And this is Ken Kreitzer for CBSI Services, talking business in New Orleans at the Card Forum. We have a new friend, Mike Golbiaski, who's a president of IBTAPPS. And Mike, good to see you. How's the conference been for you so far?
Conference has really been interesting. I mean, all the different tracks here, it's hard to catch it all because I'm specifically interested in the innovation track, but certainly looking at some of the topics there, I would have liked to have spent a little bit of time in those tracks as well. So, and I know I don't believe they're being recorded, so it's not like I can look at them later.
Well, it's good to chat. Now, first, if you would, tell us about your company.
Well, Integrated Bank Technology is based in Austin, Texas, and we provide all services for financial institutions, core processing, internet banking, mobile banking, document imaging. We're a full service provider, but we're a privately held company. We're not on the public in the public arena.
Very good. Now, one question that's, everyone talks about being mobile first, and it's hard. Let's say you're a credit union, to be able to implement that technology. Mobile is so important. Tell us a little bit about how you help a bank with installing a mobile solution.
Well, what's really important is to make sure that they get the right platform for mobile and they add the right content in their mobile platform. But the most important thing really is to, in whatever functionality you're providing, is to minimize the friction to the customer so that they're so it's easy to use and they're able to do their business with the financial institution with the minimum amount of effort, so to speak.
Now, you mentioned a special mission you're on at this conference, a particular aspect of managing transactions involving receipts. Tell us a little bit about it and if you found a solution yet.
Well, you know, I'm here really to find out, since this is a payments forum, to see where in the thinking of innovators today, where they're looking at digital receipts. Now, digital receipts, unlike digital receipts, when you speak about it today, people think about Square, where they, in essence, email you a receipt. That's a fairly ineffective model, only because if you then go to your banking site and take a look at the transaction that posted to your account, whether it's a credit card or debit card, to find the receipt, you got to go through your emails to try to find the receipt if you're going to return an item, if it's a merchant thing. Digital receipts, if done properly, actually link the receipt at the time that you go to your bank portal or your mobile portal, look at the transaction, and be able to get the receipt, just like today, people get check images when they look at a transaction on their mobile platform or their banking platform. It's efficient for the merchant because think about being able to tap your card and walk away and not worry about the receipt because it's going to be sent to your digitally sent to your home banking site or your mobile platform. And there isn't a richer amount of data. When we talked in this conference, we were talking about how important data is for analytics. It doesn't get any richer than digital receipts. I mean, all of the data down to the line items of what you purchased are part of the digital receipt, and all of that could be then driven into an analytic model.
Very good. Well, you certainly are learning the new technology. Tell us, if you would, a little bit about your career and some of the steps along the way and how you've kept up with all the waves of technology that we've seen.
Well, I've been around for a long time. I started out in this industry in 1970, and I've seen it all. And when you think about where we are today, when I started out, they still had passbooks, and the only reference you had to your account is going to the bank and updating your passbook. Today, you know, you get alerts on your balances, you get alerts when a transaction is processed. Innovation has been absolutely phenomenal in the financial services industry. And it continues to do exactly that. So I've seen it all. I've gone through periods where interest rates were 18%, and it was difficult for any financial institution to invest in technology in that type of environment. And down to where we are today, it's just been a really interesting career in the financial services. And I've worked for Ross Perot when he was doing facilities management, you know, in Chicago. and I essentially got into a merger with Integrated Bank Technology in 2008, and we've had a really great run since then, 10 years.
Well, that's great. Is there a secret to being able to keep up with the learning, the technology, all the things that we're seeing at this conference? Is there a secret that's enabled you to keep up with everything that's been going on?
Well, really what I've always done is I've gone to technology conferences, not necessarily always banking related or payments related. I've gone to general technology conferences so that I could keep up with what's happening in the industry and see how that will apply to financial services and banking. And that's really been the key to keeping up with what's going on.
Lifelong learning, and you're obviously a master of that. Mike Olbiowski, president, tell me the name, how you pronounce your company name.
IBT Apps, APPS.
Okay.
IBT Apps.
Very good. Well, delightful to meet you here at the Card Forum, and thanks for chatting with us.
Thank you.
Pleasure. This is Ken Kratzer for CBSI Services Talking Business at the Card Forum in New Orleans.